All right, welcome back. You're watching Morning Express live here on KTN News. Today on Your Health, we're taking a look at yoga. So yesterday across the world was Yoga Day. Of course, India is very popular for doing this, but countries such as China, Britain and Malaysia took part in it. And right here in Kenya, it's becoming quite popular. So in studio, I am joined by Lorraine and Catherine, who will take us through a yoga class. But first of all, questions that maybe you might have, and they'll be here to help us understand yoga a bit more. Ladies, welcome to KTN News Morning Express.
Thank you.
Would you like to introduce yourselves to Kenyans? Let's start with Lorraine.
My name is Lauren Mwamra. I am a yoga enthusiast, but also an indoor cycling instructor.
Awesome, Lorraine. Yes. Okay, Catherine.
My name is Catherine, and I'm a yoga instructor with Africa Yoga Project.
All right, so Catherine is the one who's going to take us through those hard yoga classes. Please be kind to us. Not all of us are flexible. Either way, let's begin. There's a myth about yoga. I think that's where we should start the conversation from. That yoga is all about sitting still and letting your soul leave your body. I don't want any soul leaving my body. You know, I was telling Michael that. Is that a myth? Is it true? Are there different types of yogas? Help us understand.
When you do yoga, first of all, you're not going to sit down. Mm-hmm. You're not just going to sit down. You'll be really moving your body.
Okay.
So use the weight of our bodies to exercise through yoga. And your soul will not leave your body. Yeah, you still have your soul. The only thing that will leave your body is stress, inflexibility, bad energy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all those stuff will leave. But the good things will stay, including your soul.
Speaking about that, give us more reasons why Kenyans should partake in yoga. Because we know it's not a culture within the African continent. So why should I partake in yoga? What will it do for me health-wise?
There's a lot of benefits of yoga that a lot of people don't talk about. Mm-hmm. But if you come to a yoga class, you'll get to understand. Like, first of all, it really helps in strengthening our muscles and toning our bodies. And also psychologically, when you do a lot of yoga, you are able to release stress. And there's your immune system get boosted. If you don't sleep well, if you try to do yoga, you start to sleep well every day.
All right, Lorraine, yeah. I know you started yoga about 2 years ago,
Yeah, 2 years ago.
Tell us about your experience.
Well, a friend of mine dragged me. He said, there's a class, and it's a free class. I know AYP do that. So Saturday class, he said, come over. And yeah, I haven't stopped till then.
Now, the fact that you started like some of us who are not flexible at all, I mean, how long does it take until you get into the groove of it, especially if you've not been doing it?
Actually, as I think I was telling someone, yoga is for those who've never done it.
Mm.
You want to try something new? Mm. By all means, try it. Mm. It is for... It builds you as you go. I'm sure the first class is hell. I will not lie to you. The first class is hell.
It's bad.
It's not bad.
It's not bad.
Very physically challenging.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah. It is physically challenging. But after that, you grow. It doesn't get easier. You get stronger. So that's the thing.
I like that.
Yoga.
It doesn't get easier. You get stronger.
Yes. Yeah.
What are some of the things it's been able to do for you?
Health-wise. Maybe. Health-wise. I think maintaining my posture was my biggest issue, actually. So maintaining posture it's subconscious. So
some switch went on
exactly,
when you started doing it.
Exactly. So that's what about.
Both of you were talking about classes. So I'm a Kenyan watching at home.
Mm-hmm.
How is it pocket friendly? Can I be involved with it? Where do I find these classes? Because I would like to you, when I began yoga, which was last year, I did it for 2 months and something happened. I don't know. It was so difficult. And I just would do it through YouTube. You know, I just would Google YouTube videos and they will pop up. Because I don't know about classes in Kenya. And are they affordable? Are they pocket friendly? Tell us about that, Catherine.
Yeah, with the Africa Yoga Project, we have yoga for everyone. Mm-hmm. So we have... we have like over 100 yoga teachers in Nairobi and all over Africa teaching to free yoga classes in communities where they won't afford a yoga or they'll never get into a yoga studio. Those are places like in Kibera, Kariobangi, all the slums around Nairobi. We're in schools, like government schools, we're teaching free yoga classes. So if you can't afford yoga, find a yoga class next to you. If there's a community hall in your neighborhood, I'm very sure there's yoga in your neighborhood.
Mm.
Also, we have a space in Parklands, Diamond Plaza, where like our class is 700 per class, so it's pocket friendly. And then if you have a lot of money and you don't want to go through traffic, we have one-on-one classes where you get to pay at least 2,000.
So you'd come to my home and we'll do a session?
Yes.
Wow. All right.
So make sure we reach everyone.
That's fantastic. There's something that you mentioned. You said that you're also taking it to government schools.
Yep.
I like that. I like the fact that you guys are involving the kids and you're taking it to schools, which is important when it comes to health and kids. But can someone who, my grandmother who is 60 and maybe a nephew who is 12 years old, can they partake in yoga without it doing any health, you know, damaging their health?
Yes, yoga is for everyone. There's yoga for kids and there's yoga for adults.
So
yoga
for the elderly?
Yeah, and elderly. For elderly, you want to take it easy and slow and make sure you're really focusing on strengthening of especially the spine. Mm-hmm. For young people, it's like power, energy, handstands, all those stuff. For kids, it's a lot of fun games and a lot of education about our environment.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, now both of you ladies are doing this somewhat of a career. I'm sure someone also at home might be interested from that angle. Lorraine, maybe you could begin with us. Talk to us about having to do it as a career, especially you said you're a cyclist in terms of professional. Then we'll come to Catherine. Take us through that.
After my introduction to yoga, I just decided, I think it was late last year, I got out of, you know, corporate career, and I just decided I wanted to do something to do with health.
Yeah.
So initially, it was personal training and a bit of yoga, but then now we are involved with a great, amazing company. It's called Zen Cycle, and we are an indoor cycling company, and what we do is literally... a full body workout on a bike.
Wow. Here in Kenya.
In Nairobi.
I can walk into and I'll find you. There's a class.
Yes, there's a class. We are opening soon in hopefully next month.
All right.
But we have small groups of classes that we could take corporate as well.
That's fantastic.
Yes.
All right. And for you career-wise, you said you left the corporate world.
Yes.
Is that a move that you regret? Has it been good for you?
I haven't regretted. Wow. I love my job. I love doing yoga. Actually, at some point we talked with Catherine and AYP. I was supposed to do teacher training. It's still in the plan at some point. But yes, I would love to be an indoor cycling instructor and a yoga instructor.
Okay, all right. So that is cycling. Catherine, yours is strictly yoga?
Yeah, full-time yoga teacher.
Talk to us about that career-wise.
It's like the best career you can ever find in the world.
Not after my job, after my job.
Because I get to be, I get to go to people and really see them changing their life through practicing. I get to be involved with in major life changes in people, not only in back in my community, not only with our yoga teachers, but also with people like you at home. Like I'm here talking about yoga and how it is transforming life in Kenya. We see, we work with youths who are really unemployable. And I'm talking people who did not finish their school. Maybe they were doing something illegal to get their cash, or they had nowhere to go, so we give them scholarship. And we is Africa Yoga Project, we give them scholarship and took through them a 200-hour teacher training for yoga. And then they can go back, teach free yoga classes to their community as they get paid by our organization, get the skills that will give them tools to be professional yoga teachers. And now, like in Kenya, we have in Africa, we have the most trained yoga teachers and the best and the most professional yoga teachers.
Right here within the African continent.
Yes. And they're teaching all over.
All right.
Like I think now we have a plan to start teaching yoga to Nakumat staff.
Why are you not bringing it to KTN?
Well, yeah.
In our audience.
Who are we going to talk to? Hey, KTN, start doing yoga.
All right. Let's also talk about some of the myths that are there within yoga.
Yeah.
Of course, we've already cancelled out one, the fact that, you know, does it involve the spiritual aspect? You clarify that for us.
It all depends on what spiritual aspect you need. So if you're asking if it's religious,
yes.
So it's very important to say yoga is not religious. It's you won't be praying any god. So it's an exercise that does exercise your whole body and your mind. So the only difference between yoga and other exercises is that it works out your body and your mind, your emotions. So yeah. Your religion will still be your religion.
Your faith, it will remain intact.
Yes.
All right, fantastic. So I'm really eager to get this class going on.
Yes.
Our viewers at home can definitely send in their questions. If you have any comments, Catherine and Lorraine are here to clarify that. And please be easy. Some of us are not like very flexible people. So I hope you will take us through it very easy.
Okay.
So this is your class now.
Okay.
So you will take that mat and I'll stand right here.
Lorraine, and I'll be practicing with you guys.
This is your class. Tafadhali, take us through it.
So we're going to start with a pose called a child's pose.
Child's.
So you just come onto your knees, allow your big toes to touch at the back.
Mm-hmm.
Then you open your knees as wide as your mat, extend your hands forward, and rest your forehead on the floor.
Oh my gosh.
And this is a very relaxing pose. And if you notice, you're lengthening your spine here, so you make sure you're sitting deep onto your heels and you're extending your fingertips to the front. Really, really good for your lower back.
Mm, I can feel that burn.
Yeah. Take a deep breath in here and a long breath out. One more breath in. Breathe all the way out and slowly come up on your fours, your hands and your knees. And you want to check in your shoulder in line with your wrist, just to protect your joints. Mm-hmm. Inhale at your back, take your tailbone up to the sky. Now take your gaze up to the roof. Now exhale, round your spine up to the sky. Tuck your chin, and you're really warming up your spine here. Inhale, lengthen, look up. Exhale, round your spine. One more time, leg back. Inhale, look up. You're creating some motion, movement on your spine, round your spine. And come into a neutral spine. Tuck your toes under, and you're going to take the pose called downward facing dog or inverted V. You stay on inverted V, I'll just check in if you're doing it right. You make bring your feet to be hip width distance apart, so here, and then walk one step in. Not that big step, there. Yeah, mm-hmm. And the other one. Nice. Now draw your heels down. And make sure you're drawing like an upside down V. Keep your eyes at the space between your feet. You have to maintain your focus. And really, this pose, as you can see, works your hands and tones your legs. And also really nice for your spine. And also it tries to flush blood into your brain.
Mm-hmm.
You know, allowing some relaxation and clear mind.
So what if someone is flat-footed?
What do you mean flat-footed?
For example, I'm flat-footed. I have no heel.
Oh, yeah, it does. Yoga really helps a lot to bring your calf in here. Mm-hmm. So do this. Actively press your feet down, press the big toe on the earth, and try to lift the arch of your foot up energetically. So it really try to bring that space between the arch. One more breath in here. I know it's sweaty. Exhale, bend your knees, walk forward to the top of your mat and bring your feet to touch. Halfway lift, bring your hands below your knees, look forward, lengthen your spine. Forward fold, now try to kiss your knees. Drop your hands, bend your knees, kiss your knees. Uh-huh. Come all the way up to standing, extend your hands all the way up, mountain pose. And bow forward fold. Now we're going to do sun salutation A. We use sun salutations for warm up. Halfway lift. Lengthen your spine, high plank. Mm-hmm. So see, now you're not sitting.
Yeah.
Low plank.
Oh my gosh.
Uh-huh. Take upward facing dog. So pointed toes, lengthen, stretch your spine here, shoulders back. Downward facing dog. Lengthen here, pulling your heels down to the floor and push your thigh bones to the back. Stretch, warm, inhale. Exhale all the way out, bend your knees, walk or jump forward to the top of your mat. Nice job. Halfway lift, look forward. Forward fold, drop your head. Bend your knees, take chair pose. Now this is sun salutation B. Mm-hmm. Sit low. It's a really, really energizing pose. So if you're tired, you sit long on your chair, just come and do chair pose. You know, people in the office will be like, you're crazy, but you'll really be getting your energy back. And forward fold, drop your head. Halfway lift, lengthen, look forward. High to low plank, you step back. Then you bend your elbows, hug your rib cage. Upward facing dog, creating flexibility on your spine here. Downward facing dog, take your hips back. Nice, now step your right leg forward. Coming up into warrior one.
Oh, this is warrior one.
Yes.
I see people doing this on Instagram. I'm like, I got it.
And just like its name, it really helps to build your confidence. See, you feel strong here. You feel really strong on this pose. Drop your back leg down. It will strengthen your legs, you'll have nice thighs, and also lengthen this upper body all the way up and draw your shoulder blades into your spine.
So it helps with toning?
Yes.
Okay.
Hands on the floor, take downward facing dog. Step your left leg forward. You have to do both sides. Warrior one.
All right.
And again, bend your front knee. Drop your back heel down. Yeah, there you go. Keep both legs really active, fired up. You're hugging your muscles to your bones. Nice. And you have your hips squared. And with an era of smartphones and computers where we're always like this.
Yeah.
So it's really nice to open the other way. So draw your shoulders back. Open your heart to the sky. And high plank. Low plank, upward facing dog stretch, downward facing dog, push your thigh bones back and set your gaze on one point.
Katrina, I have a question.
Yes?
So I read that yoga helps reduce weight.
Yes.
After how many minutes will I start to see the effect? I'm feeling it.
If you, we do like 5 sun salutation A's, we just did one, and we do, and we do 5 sun salutation B's, we just did one. By the time we're doing the second, the 5th sun salutation B, all this place will be full of water. You'll be sweating. Yeah.
All right. I hear you.
Continue?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's more?
Downward facing dog. And now we're going to do a sequence that really help to build your energy. Step your right leg forward. And now you can keep your back foot on toes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, reach both hands up for crescent lunge. Hold it there for a few breaths here.
Oh my gosh.
And if you're doing this at home, check in with your front leg, keep it 12 o'clock, and your back heel up to the sky. Uh-huh. Now take your pelvis to be neutral. Yeah, balance here, now hands to your heart center. Press your palms together, draw shoulders back like we did, the opposite of chatting, back. Uh-huh. Now take your left elbow, to meet your right knee, nice. Press and twist.
Oh my gosh.
This pose seems like easy, but it's really good for your digestion.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it helps also to massage your internal organs and to pump fresh blood into your organs. Twist. And you're twisting out all the toxins. If you do wine, all the wines go out. All the chips. Twist.
All the fries.
Yes, and open your hands into warrior two. Again, a really strong pose here. Build strength and confidence. And take extended side angle. So have your forearm on your thigh. Take your upper hand to the sky. Look up. Then draw again, opposite of chatting. Shoulders back.
Uh-huh.
Bend your knee. Can you feel the burning on your thigh? The front thigh?
Yeah. I can feel the burn.
Yeah, there you go. And hands on the floor. High plank. Low plank for your upper arms. You know, good arms. Upward facing dog. Shoulders back. Downward facing dog, take your hips back. Do the same on the other side. Left leg steps forward and just reach both hands up. And now start to find your breath. Again, easy breath in, easy breath out. So you use the breath to calm us down. It's okay. You can drop your back knee down and reach up. So the most important, your front leg face forward, then bend your knee forward. Yeah, there you go.
Good
high. Inhale. Exhale. Use your breath to calm yourself down. Inhale. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Take your right elbow to your left knee. Press your palms, twist again. Now you're squeezing out the other way. Using your breath. And also in yoga, we use our breath to build heat.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. 2 more breaths. 1 more breath in. Exhale all the way out. Come up into warrior two. Split your hands so you take your back heel down, up. Bend your front knee. Go low. And take high plank. Uh-huh. Low plank. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Take your hips all the way back to the back. Take a deep breath in here. Long breath out. Come on your knees. Take child's pose. So in a yoga class, you can always come into this pose to rest. So if you're in any yoga class and you feel like you're too tired and your body can't take it anymore, you just come back onto this pose. Take a few breaths. Then continue with your practice. Back on your falls, your hands and your knees. Tuck your toes under, take downward facing dog. Bend your knees. Walk forward to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Forward fold. Come all the way up to standing. And now we're going to do a few standing poses here to build balance.
All right.
First pose is ego pose. Take your right hand all the way under. Mm-hmm. Yes, grab your thumb. Now bend your knees. Take your right leg over for ego pose. So keep your eyes on one point that's not moving. Now just breathe. Creating balance here. And you're not only creating your balance on your yoga pose. You can take your experience on the mat and apply it in your life. You create balance in your life. And slowly release. Left hand goes under. Left leg comes over. Make sure you cross all the way in here. Grab the thumb. Nice. Go down. Twist.
Lorraine, and you did this for 1 year?
Yes.
No.
You do it all the time. Anytime, any chance I get, I do it. Apart from indoor cycling, this is what I do.
Oh my gosh. Okay. This is harder than jogging.
And slowly release. Come down. Okay, one more pose while standing. Let's take tree pose. So for tree pose, your choice, you can either place your foot below your knee. You also need to be very careful not to injure yourself. So don't step on your knee.
Okay.
You can either place it all the way up or below here. Then bring your hands to your heart center for balance and stability. And you're looking for balance with your upper body here. Stay with your concentration. Reach both hands up. Exhale, release, come down. Switch sides. Now do tree pose on the other side.
On the other side?
Yes. You start with your hands to your heart center, shoulders moving back. You know, you're also standing up with a long spine. Reach both hands up. Your breath is fluid. And slowly release, come down. Step your left leg all the way to the back of the room, but keep your right legs facing forward. Open your hands out. Reach forward like you want to touch the cameras in front or your TV if you're doing this, and take triangle pose. Reach your left hand up, and this really stretches your hamstrings. Hamstrings are the most stubborn and tight muscles in our body, so it really helps to stretch all the muscles at the back of your legs.
I can feel that.
Yeah. But also they are really good with grounding. You know, if you're nervous, you can settle, something is disturbing you. These poses really help to ground you.
Catherine, I have a question.
Yes.
So does someone do this in the morning, at night, midday? Like, what's the best time?
My favorite time is morning, but anytime, whatever time you want to do.
Okay.
Just not after lunch.
Definitely.
Not after eating. Come up to standing, turn your feet to face same direction, hands on your waist. Inhale, look up. Exhale, turn your feet to face out, and let's do a squat here. So squats are like the trend now. Yeah. You can bring your hands out like this, so you're also on a flat spine. For one. And two. And three, slowly come up to standing. Turn your right foot forward. Close the distance between your feet. Nice, not too close. But you also want to keep your feet hip width distance apart, so your left leg slightly to the left for balance. Nice, square your hips. Reach both hands up. Now exhale, bow forward fold. Keep your right leg straight. Grab the floor or grab your shin, whichever makes you comfortable. Then you take your forehead all the way to your shin.
Oh my gosh, okay.
Yeah, again stretching your hamstrings here. And come all the way up to standing. Both feet to the top of your mat. Switch sides. Right leg steps back, wide. Open your hands. reach forward. Remember to root your feet, ground, take triangle pose. So if you see, if you look at your body, you're kind of creating a triangle shape. Now take your eyes to your upper hand. Because you know where your awareness goes, your energy will flow.
Oh, yes.
And you really want to not collapse in here. You want to open. You're creating more space on your upper back. And slowly come up to standing. Now turn your feet to face same direction. Hands on your waist. Inhale, look up. Exhale, soften your knees, then forward fold all the way forward. Drop your hands at the space between your feet. Drop your head. Come all the way up to standing, hands back on your waist. Turn your left leg forward. Close the distance between your feet.
All right, last move.
Yeah, look up. And drop your head to the earth, hands on the floor.
All right.
Stretch here.
So this is our last position.
Let's do one more last position that you must do in a yoga class. So both feet forward, lie on your back. We call it Savasana.
All right.
This is the one you should do it. Four. Straighten your legs. Yeah, and close your eyes. Just relax here.
Michael, I hope you're watching this because you have to come back and do this.
Then slowly come up to sitting. Cross your feet. Yeah, this is the only sitting we do.
All right. Okay, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Oh my, this is worse than jogging. I am...
All right. You did good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes,
thank you.
Michael?
I've also come to...
What?
So, of course, I could have done that. I could have done that. You see, I was even getting myself ready. I was getting ready. So this is where we're going to wind up the show. I need help here. So, yeah, Zinzi, thank you very much. Even this position is a little
it's
bit
difficult.
Yes.
And
especially now when I'm in a suit. But yeah, this is Morning Express. This was your health. And thank you very much, ladies. That was very well done.
Yeah.
And this is where we sign off and wish you all a fantastic day. And do stay with us right here on KTN News. Najma Ismail is coming up next with World View. And as we relax and... What was that last position that you must do in yoga?
Yeah, the one for sleep, sleeping one. Yeah.
Have yourselves a good day. So, Zinzi.
Then you sleep.
Why sleep though?
Yeah. But we know we can't be caught sleeping. We're at work.
Oh, yeah.